I'm ready. So, we got the PB&1 back. Saved a lot of time. Stuck on 1 hour in this game. But that's gonna change right now, right here.
This way!
Going up. Dr. Marv? Wait, hold up. Not Dr. Marv. I was about to say that was almost a godlike fight. Until one of my bullets went right through him.
Sarkozian? As in, from Sarkozia?
But I will take gold.
Thank you.
Like, oh yeah, best part of the run right here. It's like, oh wait, you mean the part of the game where you can almost go AFK? Yeah, no one's behind me. Good job. Get off the thing. Silent Martyr, what's up, man? Yo, you're just in time for the best boss fight of MG2. Running Man. What's up, pal? Yep, and that was Running Man. Yeah, hopefully RE4 was at least decent for you today. I know the game can be really frustrating at times. I'm actually just coming off a PB and win back on the PS2 edition. So I'm hoping I can spread some of that good luck into finally getting sub-hour on original difficulty. It's proven to be really challenging, as well as a little bit of aggravation around Messenger Pigeon RNG. But so far, we're off to a decent start. I did lose a little bit of time because of a leftover codec in the swamp. But for those coming in from Silent Stream, I am Joseph Joestar 316, and I just happened to be donning the cosplay today, which was a channel points redeem from yesterday's stream. Currently running Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake on the HD Collection version. It's not necessarily the fastest version to run, but it's just the one that I have. If you've played Metal Gear Solid 3 Subsistence, whether on PS2 or some version of HD Collection or the Legacy Collection, it's bundled as a part of Metal Gear Solid 3 Subsistence, as well as Metal Gear MSX. It could be a difficult game to learn, but it is really fun to play. You know, the music soundtrack is absolutely amazing. You know, and the play style and storytelling is really reminiscent of what leads into Metal Gear Solid 1. They do make references in this game to that. But even just like the way you progress through the game is identical. Only downside though is, yeah, there is quite a bit of backtracking. Some things you have to do are very cryptic if you don't know where to go. But even despite that, it's really a lot of fun. Okay, I actually gotta be careful. Apartheid D, quick, do something! Or not. Yep, just watch it take off. And that was IND. Box. Important that you get it. Yeah, I don't get it. Like, maybe Snake's just, I don't know, giving them a chance. Make it a fair fight. But, you know, and the sense of the run, it's like, come on, man. You know, can't you just fire the damn thing, be done with it? Or hell, why not just run past it while it's in the process of trying to take off? Just skip the fight altogether. I mean, you don't technically get any key items from it. You know, unlike most other boss fights that have a specific key card they drop. Playing some Metal Coggers. Ooh, I would like to play that game. Nope, I already got that, and remember to answer the codec too, which, you know, if you do not answer that codec when you first enter this section, even if you know where to go to save her, she won't actually be in there, which is sort of ironic because at that point of the story, she did get captured by the enemy, and she is in that room that I had to blow up the fake wall, but if you don't answer the codec, the game doesn't place her there. It's, I don't know, it's really silly, but it is easy to miss. And then we go back up, make our way to the 30th floor. Catch!
Sarkozian? As in from Sarkozia?
Alright, moment of truth. What kind of pigeon RNG are we gonna get today? Too bad. It's not the greatest, but it's not the worst. Yeah, this messenger pigeon, when it decides to land, is random. Given it has like four corners of that rooftop where it can stop. Where it spawns in as you go up is random. You know, so you're kind of dealing with a double like RNG where it's, you know, like as you're loading in. And in addition to when it actually stops on the ground and then you can pick it up and, you know, read the message on its leg and then it knows, oh yeah, you got a call. This codec frequency. Because if you don't, then you can't progress through the rest of the game. Like with Holly, if you don't answer the codec, she won't be there. And if you don't do this sequence on the rooftop, you won't be told to go find Gustava in the barracks in the fourth floor of the first building. Which is totally a drag because that pigeon can ultimately make or break your run, depending on how good of a run you have. Alright, smile for the camera. Thank you. She's over there. Alright, not gonna fall for it this time. Break time. It was a trap. Rip Gustavo. Also rip 15 seconds because of Pigeon. Oh yeah, I didn't punch him, but that's all right. He just disappears anyway. What's going on, Tyler? Behold, the four Papegas!
Sarkozian? As in, from Sarkozia?
Oh, apparently I planted an extra mine. Oh, good thing my HP wasn't, you know, too low before that happened. Those stairs. Oh yeah, that's right, they're still frozen. I gotta give it to these guards. They keep up with them.
Sarkozian? As in, from Sarkozia?
Oh yeah, that's where we're gliding. Nah, really, it's just going across the bridge. Just makes it more dramatic that way. Alright, made it. Jungle Evil. What? He that was the exact spot he was in. He didn't even move. Grenade. Oh, I see you. Get out of that corner. Do not make me chase you. Okay, he's making me chase him. Doesn't get any unluckier than that, sadly. Because that's the risk you run into. He, you know, he doesn't pop up like anywhere on that screen, but he can change corners. You know, like it's just four corners, the quadrants. And when he's going down to pop back up, you ideally want him to stay in the quadrant that you are in, like when you first start fighting. But should you move up one space, that's not that bad, because it puts you closer to the door here. But again, that just means you're gonna have to move around more, and it's less time that you're dealing damage to him. You know, because ultimately, you want to be able to beat him quickly and grab his key. You know, that's all you really care about. Now, of course, in the run that I'm trying to get done, I mean, him going across corners like that was really unfavorable because, you know, I was trying to make the choice of, you know, do I go after him or, you know, stand my ground, hope he'll just show back up, and fortunately he didn't do that. But there's still opportunities to still get this sub-hour. You know, it's just Jungle Evil is, you know, like the pigeon in a way, he just does whatever he wants. God of the year right there. Does he even check? He's like, oh man, must be that time. Ka-thunk. Ka-thunk. Well, at least he sneezed before getting out of the elevator. It's the polite thing to do, after all. Got the exclusive level 9 key card, which still feels completely unnecessary. Menu. Catch.
Sarkozian? As in from Sarkozia?
Alright, man, still in it. It's like, man, I want one of these. Think of it. Metal Gear 2, slide racing. Wait, it's no longer just Metal Feet. It's Metal Gear! Okay, I think I actually split that a little early. But it's still minuscule, I don't think it's gonna matter. The next two fights, though, will matter. God, dude, just go down already. Yeah, that definitely didn't help me. Over here. Of course you'd be at the door that I need to be in. In hell.
Sarkozian?
Oh, dude, let's go.
From Sarkozia?
Dude, there's still hope. Damn it, Holly. Oh, I mean, it's Holly. All right, run, run, run. It's the chap. Man, it's gonna be close. I mean, I want to say we have it. If just barely. If I tie again in an hour, I don't know. I don't know whether to laugh or to just throw my hands up and be like, man, what the hell is it gonna take other than, you know, ditching the body armor and not being up a pig on the Gray Fox fight. Hmm. And now for Snake's defining moment. It's like, what to do with the MSX cartridge? It's like, there's no need for that. It's definitely, Keo Marv's just popping in the MSX. Huh? Oh, wait. Without a doubt, it's definitely his. Look, it says it right here. Keo Marv. But wait, it's written backwards. But then Snake suddenly realizes, man, I went through all of this, Pigeon RNG, roasting Big Boss, literally, catching a cold for this? Snake's like, nah, I'm out. Solid Snake. Alright, man. This is it. What do we got? We did it!
Impossible! Woo! I am invincible!
Oh, by 4 seconds! Hallelujah! Man, 59-56. Sub 1 hour on both difficulties. Man, let's go. Dude, I swear to God if this tied again. You know, or if it was like 1 hour, 1 second, like if it went the other way. Oh, dude, you know, for not having best Pigeon RNG, but literally the end of the game saved this run. You know, I mean, Jungle Evil trolled me. I made up a little bit of time with the cartridge. Lost time to Gray Fox, which should have been a better fight. But yeah, the very end of the game saved this. You know, it was enough just to get it. Whew! Man, that definitely had me going. You know, at the very end, I was like, man, I really hope I didn't just throw it away with the Gray Fox fight. You know, or anything else I made mistakes on. But, dude, that was something. And, you know, like I said, once I got the sub 1 hour, we're going to upload it, even though it's not going to really move me in the boards. But just for myself, I want to be able to post it. So we can, well, not only update the thing, but we get to put it onto YouTube, baby.